Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to create a smooth glitch zoom transition in After Effects.
You sacked Nessa out of port without even firing a shot. Are you the pirate I've read about or not?
How the blaze.
So first, go ahead and create a new adjustment layer and trim it where you want your animation to start. For me, this is around 30 frames before and 20 frames after my second clip starts. Then go ahead and add these three effects. S underscore warp chroma, S underscore blur mo curves, and glitchify. Then go to the start of your adjustment layer and create a keyframe for warp amount and set it to 0. Then go to where your second clip starts and create a keyframe for warp amount and set it to 1. Go to the end and set it back to 0. Then you can close S underscore warp chroma, go to the start of your adjustment layer and create keyframes for Z dist and shutter duration. Set the shutter duration to 0, then go to the middle of your adjustment layer and set it to 5 and 0.8. Then go to the end of your adjustment layer and set them back to 0 and 1. Now open up Glitchify and create keyframes, set them to 0, and in the middle, set them to 20 and to 10, and then back to 0. Now open up the keyframes and easy ease all of them. Select the first three and open up the graph. Then click Edit Speed Graph and then copy my graph. Now open up the Glitchify Speed and Glitchify Amount keyframes and go to Edit Value Graph and copy my graph. Once you've done that, go ahead and create a new solid and set it to red, click OK, and cut it where your adjustment layer is cut. Now set the blending mode to overlay and create an opacity keyframe at 0, in the middle at 50, and at the start at 0. Now you can go ahead and add sound effects, so drag on this clean whoosh sound effect. And I'm going to want it a bit slower, so I'm going to set the time stretch to 150%. Double tap L and align it with your keyframes, so that the peak is at the peak of the keyframes. Anyway guys, that's it for today's video. If you want to apply this as a preset, I'll leave it linked down in the description below. Unfortunately, the preset was made in After Effects 2024, so it may not work in older versions. In that case, you'll just have to make it yourself. I've also left a clean whoosh sound effect that I used in the description. I hope you found the tutorial useful. Tell me any ideas you have for future tutorials or edits in the comments. See you in the next one.